Recall the basic idea of how a two-way merge works. You're initially given a bunch of input runs, each of, let's say, the same size, and each one sorted in ascending order. Your goal is to produce a single sorted output. A natural scheme based on the classical merge sort idea is to take pairs of runs and combine them in a tree-like fashion. One problem with two-way merging is that it doesn't really use fast memory to its fullest potential. Remember how merging in fast memory works? At any point in time, it uses very little of the available fast memory space. In fact, it uses just 3 L-sized blocks. There's one block for each of A and B, and one block for the output C. So, can you do better? A natural idea is to merge not 2 runs at a time, but a bunch of runs, let's say K. In fact, let's start by considering one of these K-way merges. You're given a set of K input runs, each of size S. Let's say they start in slow memory, and they're sorted in ascending order. Let's also suppose that you've chosen this value of K so that at least K plus 1 blocks of size L will fit in fast memory. Your choice of K is not arbitrary. Let's say you've chosen it so that K plus 1 L-sized blocks will fit in fast memory. This way you can reserve one block for each of the inputs, as well as an additional block for the output. Initially, you would fill the inputs with blocks of the input runs. Now, at each step of the local merge, you need to know which of the K input blocks has the next smallest item. Let's say that these shaded items are the next ones to consider from each of the K input blocks. Of these, you need to somehow find the smallest. Let's say that's this item. We'll come back to precisely how to find it in just a moment. You can move this smallest item to the output buffer. The next item from the source buffer now becomes active. You then repeat this process. For instance, maybe this first block has the next smallest item. So move it and make the item that follows it active. As with two-way merge, you will at some point fill the output block. When that happens, you just need to flush it. Similarly, you will at some point exhaust one of the input buffers. Again, if there are any unread blocks of the input that remain, you just refill it. Now let's return to the question, how should you pick the next smallest item from the input frontier? You have several natural options. For instance, one simple way is to do a linear scan. This is fine if K is small. Otherwise, you might consider some type of priority queue data structure, like, say, a min heap. Let's say we go with a min heap. It would then have the following operational costs. After loading the first K blocks, you'd have to build the heap, which would cost you O of K operations. Then, anytime you wanted to find the next item to merge, you'd call an extract min, which would cost you log K operations. And after you extract an item, you might need to replace it, which would also have a logarithmic cost. Now remember, these are all fast memory operations. So when we consider these costs, we'll just count them as comparisons. Now, assuming a heap-based implementation, what's the cost of a single K-way merge? Let's start with slow-fast memory transfers. You only ever read distinct input blocks once, and you only ever write distinct output blocks once. So that's 2KS over L block reads and writes. What about comparisons? First, there's the initial cost to build the heap. Then, every one of the K times S items is eventually either inserted or extracted. Since each insert or extract costs you O of log K comparisons, then that's an additional asymptotic cost of about KS log K comparisons. Remember, that's for a single K-way merge. Now's a good time to pause before seeing what happens in the full K-way merge tree.